हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर विजनरी क्लासेस। टुडे आवर लेक्चर सीरीज विल बी दी ऑन दी मिनरल्स एंड इट्स प्रॉपर्टीज। ओके, सो बिफोर वी विल लाइक टू स्टार्ट आवर लेसन, प्लीज रिक्वेस्ट यू टू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल एंड कॉन्टैक्ट अस फॉर द लेटेस्ट स्टडी मटेरियल एज वेल एज जॉइन आवर अकेडमी फॉर द रेगुलर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। ओके, सो let's move on to minerals. Okay, so what do you know about the minerals? That is a question. Okay, so minerals are the naturally occurring inorganic substances that are orderly, having atomic structure with a definite chemical composition as well as the physical properties. Okay, so what does a mineral means? It is a naturally occurring substance. Okay, second point is it is an inorganic substance. Okay, third point is it has an orderly atomic structure. Okay, then it has a definite chemical composition as well as physical property. Okay, so composed of two or more elements is the requirement for a mineral. Okay, so minerals like sulfur, copper, silver, gold, graphite are single element minerals, means there are both single element minerals as well as two or more elements minerals. Okay, so what does mineral have? Okay, minerals actually have the constituents of the elements that are arranged in a orderly fashion like this. If we consider, this is the elements. So this is the structure, okay, of that mineral that is arranged in a orderly fashion, while minerals are the building blocks of the rocks. Okay, those are seen in two complementary ways. The first way is the crystal or the grains that are observed through naked eye, while as a assemblage of sub microscopic atoms. Okay, here is an example of calcite mineral. You can see this is the structure of the calcite mineral, okay, which is found in deep inside the foraminifera ooges. What is this foraminifera ooges? It are the ooges that are found in the oceanic crust. Okay, these are the ooges that are found in the oceanic crust. These are the foraminiferas. Okay, these are the micro fossils. Okay, what does we know about the formation of mineral? Okay, so if we consider the formation of minerals, it is formed from the process of crystallization. Okay, so minerals are formed from the process of crystallization. Okay, so in which the atoms of a gas or a liquid come together in proper chemical proportion as well as crystal arrangement, it gives rise to the formation of minerals. So basically, formation of minerals is caused by the crystallization process. Okay, so what happens when a magma, hot and molten liquid rock, crystallize into a solid form, it gives rise to minerals. Actually, it happens when the magma cools. Okay, so for example, a magma falls below its melting point, which may be higher than 1000 degrees Celsius, give rise to crystals of silicate minerals such as olivine or feldspar begin to form. Okay, so this is the kind of our formation of minerals as an example. Okay, so here we can see there are some strong bonds as well as weak bonds in a graphite crystal. Okay, so here is the structure of the graphite crystal that are connected through weak as well as strong bonds. So this is the orderly arrangement of atoms that are present in the graphite. So basically, minerals have orderly arrangement. Okay, now moving on to the other polymorph of our carbon, that is the naturally diamond, is formed very high pressure and temperature condition in the earth mantle. Okay, its carbons are closely packed. So here you can see the carbons are very closely packed. So the structure of diamond is little bit different. So we can know that if we have same elemental composition, we have different kinds of minerals. We can have different kinds of mineral based on their arrangement of the atoms. Okay. So these are the two types of carbon type minerals that are graphite as well as diamond. There are basically some common minerals that forms the rock. As we know, the minerals are the building block of the material. There are some minerals that leads to the formation of the rocks. Okay, so all the minerals have been grouped into 8 classes according to the chemical composition. Okay, so according to the chemical compositions, the minerals are divided into 8 classes. Okay, out of which 6 classes are listed here. The first one is the native elements that have no charge, like copper metal example, while oxides and hydroxides like oxygen and hydroxide are the second defined ion anions that are present in the minerals, like hematite and brucite, as well as some halides are also categorized in the forms like chloride, fluoride, bromide, iodide. The example is the halite for that type of minerals. Now the carbonates is also there. So in carbonate we can see CO3-2- anion, which give rise to calcite, as well as there is sulfate that is having anion SO4-2- that give rise to anhydride calcium sulfate. Now the silicate minerals are also there that give rise to silicate ions. Example of that is olivine. This mineral is present in the mantle of our earth crust. Okay, so here we can see there are some crystallographic structure of the chemical species. Okay, the first one showing that the silicate ions form a tetrahedral with a silicon ion surrounded by the 4 oxygen atom. So this is the kind of structure that is shown by the silicate types of minerals that has tetrahedral in structure. Okay, while we can see the quartz is made up of silicates tetrahedral arranged in the same way as in tetrahedral in diamond. So quartz is a silicate polymorph of our quartz structure. Okay, so you can see here. Now the third one is tetrahedral arranged in other way are the characteristics of other silicate minerals and determine their cleavage directions. So basically what does it means? The arrangement of the different chemical species in a crystalline structure give rise to different kinds of mineralogy with a different kinds of chemical classes. Okay, so this is the type of chemical classes we are dealing with the minerals. So here we can see that the physical properties of a particular mineral. Okay, so what are the physical properties? The first physical property that we are dealing with are the hardness. Okay, so hardness is a measure of ease. That means the easiest way measure with which the surface of a minerals can be scratched. Means we can scratch a mineral surface. How easily is the measure of hardness that we are seeing in a mineral? Okay, so for example, diamond is the hardest mineral. Okay, so it can scratch the glass. So as the quartz crystal, which is much harder than feldspar, can scratch the feldspar crystal. So the more hardness, the more stronger it is, the less hardness, the less stronger it is. So this is the concept you should know behind this. Okay, in 1822, Frederick Moho, an Australian mineralogist, devised a scale known as the Moho scale of hardness based on the ability of one mineral to scratch the another. So this is the sequence. Okay, this is the sequence of the hardness. The first in the sequence is the talc. Okay, this is the talc minerals. The second is the gypsum. The third is the calcite, the fourth is the fluorite, the fifth is the apatite, the sixth is the orthoclase, the seventh is the quartz, the eighth is the topaz, the ninth is the corundum, and the tenth is diamond. So up to this you should remember for the exam, because this is the actual Mohr scale of hardness you should know about. So here we can see there is a given that this is the relative hardness. Actually the hardness, absolute hardness differs a little bit. We can see the hardness of talc is 1 while the gypsum is 2. So if we consider the diamond's absolute hardness is 1500, that means it is 1500 times more harder than the talc, while relatively we should write like this in this format as we have written in the hardness. Okay, so what do we read here? We are reading here actually on the point of exams we should remember that number of silicate minerals present in a Mohr scale of hardness is 4, that is talc, orthoclase feldspar, quartz and topaz, while the number of fluorine rich minerals is 3, that is fluorite, apatite and topaz. Similarly, you should remember about the phosphate, that is apatite, that is present in our mineralogical hardness scale. Okay, so this is the topic of hardness of physical properties. So the second most important physical property is the cleavage. Okay, so what does cleavage is means? It is the tendency with which a crystal breaks along the flat planar surface. So what does this shows? That if we cut a mineral like this, if we cut the mica, okay, it shows a shining sheet surface while we cut this mica. So this is the cleavage plane, okay, planar surface along which the mineral is the cut very easily. So this will must be planar surface, it should not be rough surface while we cut the mineral. Okay, so this describes basically the geometry of mineral on the breakage. Okay, so cleavage varies inversely with the bond strength. This is the very important point. Cleavage vary inversely with the bond strength. High bond strength produces more cleavage and vice versa. Okay, so here is an example of the mica crystal. Let us see this example. We can see that silicate layer is above, then a aluminium hydroxide layer is in between. The aluminium atom is present inside that aluminium hydroxide layer. Then again there is a silicate layer. So there is a sandwich layer between these two type of silicate layer. So if we cut from the middle of this sandwich layer, we should see there is a particular type of cleavage like this. Okay, so this is the cleavage in a mica occurs between the sandwich layer. So this is the, we can see also some potassium atoms are also present between this. Okay, so this is a kind of mica structure we can see here. So here we have shown a practical example. While we cut a mica, we get such a shining surface in a planar surface. Okay, now moving on to the examples, these are the types or examples of cleavage plane. Okay, so let us discuss, okay, some examples. Minerals that having without cleavage is, example is the quartz. Okay, although many minerals like quartz forms crystal with a geometric form, they may not have cleavage. Okay, some minerals may not have cleavage. If we cut them, they will cut roughly, not into a planar structure. Okay, while some cleavage in one direction, that is the muscovite, you can see this is a sheet like structure that has formed here. While some occur in the two direction, that is the feldspar, it can cut like this or it can cut like this. It will give the two types of planar surface if we cut them. Some has three type structure like halite. If we cut it in the three direction, it will have a three cleavage planes. Okay, some cleavage have also three direction, that is the calcite. It is the perpendicular one, it is the rotated cleavage plane. So here we can see there are different types of cleavage plane along which a mineral can be cut out. Okay, now the second most important property after the our cleavage plane, that is the how a surface mineral reflects the light gives its characteristics. Okay, so the reflective property of a mineral give its physical characteristics. Okay, that is defined as luster. So luster is controlled mainly by the kinds of atoms present and their bonding, which affect the light passes through it or is reflected by the mineral. Suppose a crystal is there of a mineral and it is shining, so it has a shining luster. Okay, so here are some types of the luster we can see in a mineralogy, that is the metallic luster. Okay, a metallic luster have a strong reflection produced by the opaque substances which cannot reflect the light, while there are some vitreous luster, that is bright as in the glass. There is a resinous structure which is the characteristics of the resins such as amber, greasy structure, that is the luster of the oily substances, pearly structure, that is the white iridescence of a pearl-like material, silky structure, just like the silk, and the last one, that is adamantine structure, that is a brilliant luster of the diamond. So diamond has a adamantine structure which makes it so reflectivity while we see it. So these are the kind of different luster property of a mineral. Now the fourth property is the color. Okay, so the color is basically not an important property because different kind of minerals with similar composition can have different kind of color properties. Okay, so the color of a mineral is imparted mainly by the light it gets reflected. Okay, either transmitted through it or reflected from the crystal or irregular masses. Okay, or a streak. Okay, streak is a plate. Okay, that we used in a mineralogy to study the physical property. So streak refers to the color of the fine deposit of a mineral dust left on an abrasive surface. Okay, this abrasive surface is fixed, such as a tile of unglazed porcelain. So the streak plate that we used is a type of unglazed porcelain. Okay, so if we scratch a mineral like this, if we scratch a hematite mineral that is black in or brown in composition or reddish brown in composition, it gives rise to our reddish brown streak. Okay, it is although black in color, but it is giving a reddish brown streak. Okay, so this is the our type of minerals that having a different kind of color as well as different kind of streaks. Although their color is very different from the streak that they produce, but they are is the best property that we can see to determine the mineralogy. So streak is a good property instead of color to determine the mineral types. Okay, so now have a rapid revision on the different types of physical property. So the first property that we deal with, the hardness, that is the due to the strong chemical bonding that gives the hardness. Okay, while there is a cleavage, that is the cutting of a plane into a flat or planar surface. Okay, so some have ionic bond very weak and so give a excellent cleavage, while some don't have ionic bond very weak, they are very strong ionic bond, so they don't give the excellent cleavage. While there is a fracture, we can see the type is related to the distribution of bond across an irregular surface than a cleavage plane. Okay, so suppose what does this fracture mean? Suppose we have a mineral and it is cut in a haphazard manner. Okay, the two crystals will cut down in a haphazard manner, not in a plane. That it is called as fracture. While the luster is the shining property of a mineral, that also depends on the covalent bond between the crystal. The color is also determined by the kinds of atoms or ions that are present in the mineral like this. The streak is a color of a fine powder, that is the more important characteristics than the massy mineral. Because of their uniform small size grain, they give a different kind of color that is helpful in determining the mineral. Again, there is a very important property that we are dealing with, that is density. That density depends on the atomic weight of an ions or atoms and their closeness of packing in a crystal. Okay, so if they are closely packed, they are highly dense minerals. Okay, now the last one is the crystal habit. It depends on the plane of atom or ions in the mineral structure and the typical speed and direction of the crystal growth. Okay, so these are the crystal habitat. So these are basically the different kind of properties that a mineral have. We should discuss it in the later section in detail. Okay, so we have some different types of minerals according to the chemical composition also, that are the hydrous mineral. So what does the hydrous mineral means? Minerals containing a water in their structure are known as the hydrous mineral. The hydrous mineral are like gypsum, has a chemical formula of calcium sulfate dot 2H2O. So there will be a water molecule in this mineral. The larger the number 2 in front of 2H2O signifies that there are 2 water molecules for every molecule of calcium sulfate. I hope you should know these basic things about the minerals, And if you have some doubt, you should ask me in the comment box. I will answer you. And if you have some more doubts on this kind of mineralogical, physical and chemical properties, you should ask me. I should make some new videos according to this. With thanks, have a nice day.